Good afternoon, passengers. I'm Colonel Failure, and this is Transport Fever. We're moving at a somewhat rapid pace at the moment. We're just moving things along a little because I'm trying to pay debt down a little enough so that I can do the next grand scheme. As the Alco PA pulls into Warren, no, Henderson. I don't know why the name doesn't stick with me. It just doesn't. But there you go. Yes, the Alco has just pulled into Henderson, and as has its comrade, and they're both packing out. Just about every time. So that's that one. This one's got 79. Yeah, that's all right. That's pretty good. I had anticipated seeing a metro liner at this point. That would have been useful, given that last time we focused very heavily on metro liners, and there should be a whole slew of them operating around here. Oh, look, there we go. There's one obliging us now. Hello, friend. How are you today? Which line are you running on? Boss Pem. A good line. Today, what are we going to be playing at today? I've got some stuff to figure out, and that just exhibited one of the things that I've got to figure out. So stay tuned, and the figuring out will occur. After the last instalment of High Octane Entertainment, several of you made comments vis-a-vis errors that I had made in setting up the lines we're running here. And this chap here is running on Boston to Pembroke Pines, and it omits to stop at Warren. Henderson, for crying out loud. It fails to stop at Henderson on the way back, which is... that's an error. That's an error, that is. Yeah, so, you know, we'll add that in now. There we go. Fixed it. Are we doing everything else? Warren, Boston, Warren. That's fine. Indianapolis, Henderson, Pembroke Pines, Henderson, Indianapolis. And it goes. Warren, Boston, Warren. Good. Okay, that's that one. Right, where's the other one? I just want to check we've got that right. I've got a couple of corrections to make here in order to maintain sanity. On a central line, which is still not fully packed out, goes Pembroke, yes, Indianapolis, Warren, Boston, Warren, Indianapolis. That's right. There's nothing missing from that one. Okay, that's fine. Go on, pick up more than you had. 66. It's not a big number. But those will be, and a lot of those will be people who came on from Pembroke who wanted to go to, you know, Warren, which for some reason I have a fixation with, or Boston. Also, it was suggested that these signals here that are in the tunnel are both on the same side of the track. And following an intense investigation on my part, they are. Now, I don't know if you can make this out, right? But there's one, right, which is catching this side of the track. And my intention was to put the other one on that side of the track, but I haven't. I've actually got it facing in the opposite direction. So if traffic were going the same on the same bit of track, it would be blocking both sides. But instead, it's potentially causing mayhem. So the first thing is track it down. If I remove this bit of track, then, you know, there's going to be disaster. There has to be an easier way to find stuff in tunnels. That's it. Right. See? I managed to do that without creating mayhem. And then we'll stick it on the other side. That's just for spacing purposes, to ensure that trains don't get too close together. There's no other reason behind that. Anyway, last year we brought in 13.6 million. Tasty. And it's looking like we're going to do something similar this year. Do I want to throw... I'll throw it all in, and then we'll take it all back out as the need arises. So, a brief review. We've had a good 3-4 episodes of radical improvement. So, a brief review of what we've got coming up next on the old project sheet. First thing is to re-establish this food goods line. It was close to profitable, it was just badly set up. The number of people who have gone, run the train all the way up to the farm, and it will be better. Large number of people with that suggestion. Equally, just move the port or the services the port is providing down to the lake, where it's easier access for all of the ships you've got going on, and it's also closer. I can't argue with that. That's a great idea. I'd need to find a suitable method of transporting stone. But, you know, I'm already quite excited at the prospect of running a big train to kind of fulfill this. Where I need to do more work than I have done previously is in figuring out actually what's the best method of distribution that ensures that production rates go up and the cost of running trains is kept down. I mean, one of the things that will help with that is, I mean, certainly on the initial kind of supply train, so for stone, for example, it could come up here and then take back any construction materials that have been generated, as is happening at the moment, which could then be truck distributed all the way into Flint. But then saying that, why would I do that? If I've already got a line that's running here, or, well, it's more likely... Let's do a little bit of scheming here. And yes, I am filling just a little while I build up some cash. And I have absolutely no idea what I'm going to do. Well, I've got an idea what I'm going to do today. So what we'd want is a max length station here so that we could really pack in as much farming goods as possible. So we'd probably put it about there. No. I'm trying to link to the truck stop rather than the actual farm. So probably put it about here. Now, I don't know what the impact of removing fields is likely to be. I would be surprised if it was nothing. But yeah, so put a station about there. Wait for, you know, fill it up as best as can be accomplished. And then trot on over to our food production facility. Delete this station. Relay these tracks, which have been relayed about 8 or 9 times by now, in order to parallel up with the food plant, and then with the other 2 or more platforms that we set up there, have those running the good services into Boston, Warren, and beyond. That's what I'd do with that. I mean, it's quite a bit of building. I can afford to do it now. But let's pay down, keep paying down. See, we're already back down from, you know, high 90s into the high 50s. So, you know, that's 40 million paid off in a couple of years. It's, you know, these passenger services really are, you know, making good money. And long may it continue. Once I have the airports running again, we're on to project 2 now, folks, project 2. Once I have the airports running again, because they are mothballed for the time being, I'll replace this shuttle service that we've got going on now, which is ancient. 21 years. It's getting on for being ancient. I'll replace that with a metro line of service that does something. And it might just shuttle between Warren and Boston with a stop in between, which should just service the airport and nothing more. Don't know yet. We'll see. Next project beyond that, and the secret to getting this operational, this end, actually, the Boston end, is fine. That'll work just fine. The other end, we could do with, so the other end back out in San Bernardino, is also, you know, this will also work fine. The trick, the secret to making that work is employing enough aircraft. And that's all it was. The reason the Dakota, at the end of its lifespan, had started picking up passengers all of a sudden was I had 3 of them on it. The reason the jets weren't working is I only had 2. That was it. That's through my extensive research, that was the only reason it wasn't making any money, is I needed 1 more jet on there. And then it starts making really good money. So, you know, that's an easy win, right? That's one we can all get behind and, you know, blow our trumpets. The San Bernardino to Santa Rosa line itself needs an update. It's serving its purpose perfectly well. I'm not sure if it's profitable. Where are we? Let's put this front and center. I think it might be a loss maker. Let's have a look. There it is. No, that's an airport shuttle. That's fine. Yes, here we go. San Bernardino Santa Rosa is losing money, and the reason it's losing money is for no other reason than it started getting a bit slow. It's also pretty flipping old, 64 years old, in fact. It's costing me more than it's making right now. I could easily do just a very swift engine update on that to get it up to something a little bit more modern, a little more pacey, but I think I'll wait until I've connected it up. I'll just swallow that cost for now, which is completely ridiculous, but I'm going to. So, you know, there you are. Right, so In terms of what would make sense, continuing on from Independence through Waterbury, Tampa, and Riverside, out to San Bernardino, I want to check it first. I'll do that in my own time. Today is not what we're going to do, that one. Which, you know, reform those words into a sentence that is coherent, if you would be so kind. Flipping heck, there's a lot of people waiting here. 262 on the main line. I could stick another one on there, which would make more money, or I could stick another coach on the back of it. I'm going to leave it alone for the moment. Yes, I am leaving money on the table, but I do that. That's what I do. I would prefer that everything was full all the time, even if that means a lot of people waiting at platforms. No, here we go. This is what we're going to do. Because we're gradually easing our way across the map, and when I reintroduce the goods line, I want to take on board Jacksonville and Pheonix as well. So I want to connect these guys up by train. Now, we could work something from Boston out in that direction, but Boston's going to head through Pheonix. And then in order to keep Jacksonville from being, you know, not being the redheaded stepchild of this map, we want to make sure that it's got a train service as well, which is going to come from Pheonix. So that's what I'm going to lay in now. Place your bets, because I've not planned this. And as such, this could be exciting. Let's go for... So this is the foundation point of the East Coast Main Line, or the Great Eastern Line, or I come up with whatever you think sounds appealing, but that's what this is going to be. Now, where do we think that the good people of Jacksonville are going to want to spread to? I think this road is not going to live for very long. I think that's going to have to get out of the way so that I can get my train track through there. Yes. Actually, before I place this, I want to have a quick look at the zones. Oh, this is great. This is right next to the residential zone. So I can just stick this here and everybody will be happy. There we go. Be happy, people. Yes. Do something like that. That's pretty ugly. Let's do something like this. What have I won? A really big boat. Splendid. And a new bus. Okay, fine. I'll play with those at some point, but I'm busy. No, go up and give. If I leave enough space here, there should be enough room for people to build houses alongside the terminal, which would be nice. Hang on, let's do that first. Here we are. So, right, what do we think? Do we think that's enough room for people to build houses? I think it might be just a little slim. Equally, you're now fighting me on linking up. Don't fight me. It's really not worth it. I'm going to win. I might win in an unconventional fashion, but I will win. There we are. Too much slope. Oh, of course there is. Actually, yeah, looking at it, that is quite slopey. What if we went the other way? This is my new trick, incidentally, is if at first you get denied, try it the other way. No, it's not working. Alright, then we'll do this first. Like that. Alright, we have left a bit of a gouge. Oh, and for those of you who were suggesting, and you know who you are, that the tree gun has replaced all smoothing in the known world, you're quite wrong. Smoothing ain't going nowhere. Look at this. See? Look, we're back down to 44K overdrawn. 44M. Not 44K, which is, you know, shocking, but at the same time, manageable. Right. Went a little bit max headroom there. Now, from Pheonix, we're going to head out to Berkeley, and then from Berkeley, we're going to head out to Hartford. We're going to head out to Garden Grove. We're going to completely ignore the city whose name one shall never speak. That city is not taking any part in this game for fear of causing offence. Right. Let's see what we get. Let's see what we get if we head out this way. We get a tunnel there. All right, let's have a look. Speculative Route 1. So we get a bit of a lump coming out of the state. That's because we're doing silly things with the road. We'll fix that. That'll cheapen it a little bit. Nice quick tunnel, I like. We could go around the outside and save, a couple of hundred thousand, I would have thought. But honestly, I quite like it. I quite like having a little quick tunnel there. But I'm going to delete all of this road, and then I'll relay it once we're tracked. Right, there we go. Let's get that rolling. Actually, what would be more sensible would be for me to put my my next station in. Now, if I want Boston to connect up to here, there's an expensive way, whack through the mountain. There's a cheaper way, come round the mountain, but it's also slower, and you still have to tunnel there. So I might as well just, you know, bite the bullet and go straight up the middle here. But I think I'm going to station up there. And again, this is largely so that I can avoid the additional expense of ploughing through that one. Right. So, modern terminal. Well, Pheonix, it's your lucky day. You are the first owner of a modern terminal. I know, you know, living the dream, Pheonix. You're the fans. You're the flames of the future. How many do I want on here? Do I want two or do I want four? It really depends if the service from Boston is going to be a backing service or not. Or a through service. I can do something clever with the route. We'll go with a two. Because I'm hoping at some point that I get a city that develops properly. Where there was one video that was part of the kind of pre-release hypeness for the game. That showed a city centre that was basically just track running through the middle of it, roads very close to the side, loads of traffic going on. And I thought, that's a good look. That's something I want to build. So I'm going to try and encourage the game to do that by making it very easy for it to cross from one side to the other. We'll see if it pays off or not. Who knows? There we go. Now, before I go any further with this, because this is costing me a lot of money, let's see what is desired from a straightforward link up on this side. Because I don't want to be digging if I don't need to. Crumbs, it is actually quite a long way. There we go. It's going to object to some of this at some point. Right, there we go. It's objected to quite a lot and wants to charge me 6 million quid. That's not inexpensive. That's certainly more expensive than the initial quote I was given. So I think we won't pursue a go there in one agenda. We will go there in two parts. The first of which is going to pop out here and cost me a million quid. Well, it is. I mean, it has managed to stay flat all the way. I mean, despite the fact we've got this raised section. That is all flat. I am reliably informed by the game that is a flat route. Now, how reliably the game has told me this, I have absolutely no idea. But that's what I've been told. So we have to put our trust in something. Before we go further, let's fight this diamond crossing, which is going to comply first time. See? Told you. Right, still got 11 million quid left. In fact, I've got more than that. I can borrow as much as I please and pay it back later. Right, I'm going to try and get round the left-hand side of this forest. I mean, I guess you'd call it a forest. I mean, it's the source of lumber. Rather than lumbar. And another broken main connection. Because otherwise it will do wonky things to my track, and my track does not need any help in being wonky. I will cover that. Well, that's ended up being a 3 million quid investment instead of a 6 million quid. So I'm saving money. Be quiet. Yes, I am. Right. Okay. Fling that down there. Now I don't. Oh, I also haven't decided what train I'm going to run on here. I might start with Metro Liners. Okay. I know. I overuse them, because they are difficulty level easy when it comes to, you know, reliable and cost effective services. I will make them longer just to make people happy, and I will try and make all the coaches the same color just to make me happy. Let's go. I don't like that. Let's go a little bit closer. There we go. Perfect. Good. That'll stop them belly aching. These guys are going to be screaming about, oh, you've severed our connection. We're oh so unhappy. You might actually be able to get across the top if you put a bit of effort in. Yeah, good. Right. Now, I don't actually need you as a... Well, maybe I do. I don't know. I do have a notion, which, for those of you who haven't been with me for ages and ages and ages, we start with a notion, which will later develop into a plan. A notion is something that could happen. A plan is something that's going to happen. Now, the fact that I use the word plan should not be inferred. You should not take the inference that it's a plan that's going to work. Do I want to spend $500,000 on that? No. There we go. Good. Answered that question. There is an easier way here, I think. Come on, up. No, that's down. Up, 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 up. Bit more. That will do. There we are. Excellent. Whoa. Don't try and get me to invest in a really expensive bit of road just because I'm using a really slow route. Look, come on, stay with me here. Stay with... Okay, that's a little bit cheaper, right? There you go. See, when you put your mind to it, you can do things a little bit less expensively, if expensively was a word, which I believe it is not. Right, anyway, that's horrible, but it's there. But we do actually have enough to set this up as a route, to set it in motion, to everything that you think. I'm going to diamond... I don't need to diamond here, actually. I only need to do one crossing, simply because this is just going to be a backing service to start with. But then we will look to expand it out to Boston, which is going to be interesting, to say the least. I mean, firstly, it's going to be coming in and out of platform, let's say, 4. I don't think I'm running anything down there at the moment. But we also have to cut across the goods line, which is pretty exciting. Also, I could fix the goods line. Just because I'm here, and because nobody's using it, and because I'll probably... Oh, dear. How many buildings is that? That's a lot of buildings I've got to delete in order to fix that. You know what? Screw it. Let's make that happen. Let's do this properly, and then it's done. And then the town can grow without further interfering. Have I got to do this one as well? Answer, yes. Oh, good lord. Well, I've committed to getting this on the flat now, so let's get it on the flat. Let's un-catenary this chap. Oh, keep it fast, but less wires. There we are. Right, is that all of it? That is all of it. The reason for that was happening, as I'm sure you're all aware, was because I laid track over road. Yeah, that's the cardinal sin. If you lay track over road, the track will adjust its height to meet the road. Now, if, on the other hand, you laid road over track, the road will adjust its height to meet the track. True stories all. Right, let's put this back in. That was expensive, but I'm thinking long term. You're gonna terrain alignment and the... Oh, it's because you've decided to build that. Well, I'm sorry, but that was part of the original. It's not too much slope. There probably is too much slope now. No, I can't do that. No. Oi! That's it. Pause. Now, I approve of you attempting to move back in, but I've got a thing to connect up first, all right? And I've already spent money on this, so given that I am prone to a gambler's fallacy, that means I am likely to spend more. Now, you're telling me there's too much slope, which is a real pity, because I've got the train track looking how I want it now. But I would still quite like a level crossing here, because I think that's quite good fun. But that is, you know, that's undoubtedly too much slope. Right, well, what else could I do with that? I mean, I've spent to get these two jokers back out of the way. Is there a plan B? I don't think there is. I think we just have to leave that as is. Or... Don't go all the way onto the track, if you would be so kind. Can we snake a bit of road in behind the existing buildings? Now, this is only being done... I've distracted myself woefully from the main thrust of our narrative today. But, you know, I get a beer in my bonnet and we have to follow it through. Maybe we just make this kind of like a service road. That could work. Also, we probably ought to try and connect the other missing piece here before doing that. Because it is kind of critical. Can we get a large on there? We can. Grand. Both figuratively and literally. Small street. Let's give that a try. Are you going to connect up without making a fuss? One, you are going to make a fuss. Two, you're not going to connect up. You're foiling a perfectly good scheme here, chum. Let's try that. This is the... Oh, hold on. Where you've deleted track rather than road. And road. Track and road just fell by the road wayside. I'm starting to regret pursuing this now. But I think it's going to be worth it if I get it even close to right. Now, is there a snap point here anywhere? Not till down there. Now, if I were to remove that, we can do that without too much... that was only 400 quid, so, you know, there's not too much wailing and gnashing of teeth going on there. Oh, now you don't want to connect back up. How jolly helpful of you. And now we have to remove... Yeah, sure, let's remove the track again. Yeah, I enjoyed it that much the first couple of times. Let's do it another three or four. You get across... Get across there, right? Now, you find a ruddy snap point. I'm not deleting that fella. He's done nothing to me. See, anywhere there would do the trick. That would just be fabulous. Or we could just... I know what we'll do. We'll put it there. We'll do exactly what I was planning to do. Mostly stick that up there like that. And then using my newfound love of scenery... We will go, well, why didn't you just connect it up to that road? Now, I could say, well, that game wouldn't let me. That game was, you know, being a flipping joker about it. But no, instead, what we'll do is we'll kind of go, these Neolithic boulders caused a significant issue in the road clearance program. So we decided to turn it into a nature reserve. Yeah, something like that. That's the reason. Sorry, couldn't be done. No amount of bulldozer was getting through there. There you are. See, that's a feature now. That's the bedrock on which Boston is built. Probably right. Back to main narrative. Okay. So the reason it's exciting coming out of Boston. I'm not even. Am I? So we've got a connection from there to the airport as well, which is fun. I want to lay in a little bit of speculative track. I won't take it all the way now, but I just want to feel for where it's actually going to end up. So I think what we do, if we just... Because we're heading for Pheonix, which is all the way through that hill. Now, what's the line like? Okay, right. Now, if I just... Bear with me here, right? I'm going to do this, right? The only reason I'm doing that is so that I've got something to snap onto to get a quote. Right? Because I suspect this is going to be an eye-waterer. Right, something like... Yeah, that was good. Right, 9 million. We can do it in a much more elegant fashion than that. But that's a 9 million section of track. Okay. We need to find a more fluid, let's say, way of getting that working. But hey, look, we've got new towns happening, occurring, going on. So let's put in a really bad depot again. I've got to sort the depot situation out. I know this. I can't just do bad depots forevermore. We have to do a good one at some point. All right, spin you around. There you are. And then we will need just an occasional signal or two. Actually, I'm going to set the game moving again. Because Metroliners are 16.5 million each. And I'm going to want a minimum of two. Signal there. Right. And then one up here-ish. And then we'll do two more just before the tunnel. Those of you who have said repeatedly that, no, don't worry about it. The trains will space themselves out. Yeah. I'm sure they will. But no, I'm not falling for that. I don't believe it. That goes double for those of you who go, you know you can drop cargo at passenger stops. Yeah, I'm sure you can. But you know what? I reckon that will be gone in a patch at some point, because that feels wrong. That feels like it's against the natural order of things, and as such should be smote from a legal manoeuvre in the game. So I'm going to continue building truck stops for trucks to stop at. Because what I don't want to have to do is relay 500 flipping truck lines when the marvellous Swiss developers decide to outlaw the stopping of trucks at passenger stops. So there you go. Those are my reasons. You may not agree with the reasoning, but I have that reasoning, and therefore, there you go. Right, bit of this, probably a bit of that. Yep. Let's hook them together. I think we'll go points rather than bridge. Points? Level crossing. Yeah, level crossing rather than bridge. See, the track is largely undisturbed, but we have got a bit of a kink in there. I'm sure it's nothing. I'm sure it'll be barely be noticeable. Do a bit of that. Right, okay. Route 1. And I've almost got enough money in the bank to buy a metro line outright. This is a good thing. Okay, we're going from Pheonix and its glorious brand new station to Jacksonville. This is actually a pretty nice route in terms of length. And it's the same, it's a little longer than Boston Warren. And Boston Warren was making me good money early on. So, you know, this should be at least able to cover its costs. So this is Jacksonville to... you do need a bit of space, yeah, because it's clearer and, you know, very much more, what do you think, it's PHX? I like PHX. Let's change this to some kind of vibranty colour, just to make sure that that's using both sides of the line correctly, which it is. Grand. Okay, good, that'll do. Train, yes, train. Do we do train next, or do we do passengers next? We do train next, because that way passengers will actually get the idea quicker. I've got enough money, we can buy one now. Do I make it hot pink? I make it hot pink. Why not? Do I want to add another wagon? I think I will. There you go, and they're all the same colour. And I've still got 4 million quid left in the bank. There are miracles happening around these parts. There we go. Set line on Jack's fix. Unable to find path stop electric. Oh, I haven't electrified the whole thing. I'm sure I did. Maybe I got distracted at some point midway through and failed to... Oh, hold on. That's the bit you need to electrify. That's kind of critical. Right. You... Jack's fix. Hold on. Something else happened. The Airbus A320. Glorious. Someone else in the comments said, like, you do know the Concorde is available, right? The Concorde has been getting a bum rep from everyone that I've seen comment on it so far, in the sense that it doesn't make you any money, doesn't get up to top speed. Concorde, I believe, may be the TGV, the TFV, whatever the localized version of the train is, that would empty your bank account in seconds in the original game. I suspect the Concorde is for this one. Am I going to use one? You bet I am. Let's not kid ourselves. It's not a practical service. Let's be unconventional here. Let's try something a bit different, because that always works out brilliantly well. I'm going to need you to get over to the other side. Let's go a little bit interesting, a little bit further. And then let's try and get a bridge over. Hang on, let's carry on going here. Because Pheonix should, possibly, experience a period of rapid development, if I get this right. Or, you know, I get the whole line set up correctly. Go on, that feels pretty close. From there, over here. Go on, that looks like a winner. It's surely a winner. I mean, that's a ridiculous bridge. Where are you colliding? Back on the original side. There we go. That's got it. I'm pretty sure we could get it lower, though. I mean, we could do lower, but it would have to be longer. Let's try that, which is possibly much longer than I actually want. See, it looks good, though. So I'll take it. Oh, and it's just slightly curved for extra cornering joy. All right, we'll keep curving. And then we'll run you out up here. That's a very speculative bit of road. If that ever gets used, it will be a modern miracle. And actually, this is now so impractical that I don't think this is going to work for me. But we're going to try it anyway. Because that's how we roll. Okay, right, so stop one. We're going to go there, around this area. And then when we're travelling on the right, because vehicles travel on the right, we'll put our next stop here, which does take in a fairly hefty chunk of the city. Right, I'll stop there, and then we'll head up here, because I want to get this chunk up here. So if we go about there, going to need a smidge more road. Actually, we could cheekily apply a smidge more road through here, look. There we go. And then back on the old bus stop, we want to... In fact, that one has possibly got coverage over this side already. Yeah, it almost certainly has. Everything's driving on the right, so we're on this side. I think it's still good. So there is going to be a little bit of stop cannibalization going on, but I think it'll be all right. New line. One and two and three. Oh, which route have you decided to take there? Yes, you have done the one that I prescribed. Let's go. I just want it to show up, alright? That's all we need you to do. And then that one. And then this one. That's a pretty good route. I might at some point set these routes up to reverse back onto themselves, but for now I'm just going to leave it as it is, because it's paying off everywhere else that I'm doing it, where we're getting solid numbers of passengers turn up at the station. Right, let's go for a truck and bus, a depot. Now, if I stick it... Hold on, no, that's the route to Indianapolis. I want the route to flipping Jacksonville, which is the other way, as you well know. Is there... Oh my god, the route to Jacksonville is enormous. Oh, this should be very popular. Alright, well, we're going to need two depots for this then. But, you know, such is life. Right, we'll start with four. We're gonna take a confident and bold start. We're gonna put them hot pink, the same way as everything else in this area is gonna be, and we will go with 4, 2, 3, 4. Set line on the Pheonix commuter. And then we'll do exactly the same thing, only better and more glamorous down in Jacksonville. Jacksonville, probably the last recipient of an old era terminal. Actually, look, we're spending quite heavy on this bit, so let's make this modern as well. Where's my upgrade button? There's the upgrade button. Oh, you have to click that, don't you? I want this. Modern. There we go. Modern terminal. Oh, God, that's stripped all of the soul out of it. Never mind. I mean, it fulfills the same function, I suppose. But, oh, that's a joyless building. Industrial Revolution or get out. Right about there. Right, and then that's going to that. Come on, don't fight me here. Auto save. So that's going to pick up this chunk as well, but shouldn't. This makes sense in my head. If you're visiting my head at the moment, it makes sense to you too. But if you're not, then you know that's just going to leave you puzzled. There we are. Stick that in there. There we are. That's better. So then if we work our way back out over here and then connect up there, and we've got a route is what we've got. Right, give me some. Right about there, I would have thought. Now this should lead to enough catchment in the central sections that people can kind of walk to get to a stop. It's not 100% desirable. What would be, you know, what would be effective would be a simple point-to-point route from here up to the centre of town and back again. That would work. That would pay off. There would be money in that. But I'm trying to avoid running too many routes. Just because I want to keep this game running for so that I can kind of complete what I'm trying to do. Have I done everything there? It's only a five stopper. Okay, well, fair enough. Jax, commuter. And then, yeah, depot. Yeah, have another one. I'm paying enough for depots anyway. I might invest in a depot company in my next life. And then we'll buy some of these. And Jacksonville also going hot pink. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we are. And then set line to the Jax commuter. There we go. All of you, stroll on. And, as luck would have it, we have enough money in the bank for another metro liner. Road vehicle 19 has reached its lifetime. Well, what does it want? A medal? Maybe it wants to retire, perhaps. 16.5. Right, we're going to have to wait for some cash to come in. Come on, cash. Come in. Now this is speculative because we're going back in time. Realistically, we're going back to the start of actually trying to build up tracks and what have you, as we did in the first place. So we are, because neither of these towns are connected to anywhere at all. They're going to have to do it all from the get go. Are you carrying anything? Nothing, and that's a bit of a worry. I would have expected it to be doing something by now. Well, we've got one waiting at Jacksonville, I suppose. Before it changes its mind. That was more of a kind of princess pink, that one. And then one of those. There we are. Excellent. Get to work. Jacksonville, Pheonix. Off you go. There we are. All done. Money left, which has just been eaten by the end of the month. But, you know, that's okay too. We can deal with that. Now, here's the point where we're going to find out, are these going to auto-space? Now, the signals are going to do a perfectly adequate job of keeping them apart, but not by much. So what should happen is when this guy gets up to... If the urban legends are to be believed, then this guy will go straight in and out of the station, and then the next one will go into the station and wait. Now, given that this is a single point-to-point service, it should wait until the other one is down the far end. If it doesn't do that, I'm going to point at every single one of you who says that trains will auto-space and say, no, you are incorrect. They do not. So here we go. This is you versus the game. How much belief do you have in the game? Because it's about to be put to the test. Beep, beep. Right. So, train 13 here should wait at Jacksonville. At Pheonix, rather. Until train 14 here reaches Jacksonville. There we go. We're in the station. Now, it is doing extended waiting already. No! It's not! It's leaving the station! Oh my! You are all incorrect, internet commenters! I am vindicated! Right, you, stop. They're not trying to space themselves out in the slightest. That was an immediate turnaround. That was just a standard loading wait. There we go. You've seen it here. That's a proof. Trains don't auto-space. Space them manually or use signals to do it. There you go. I require documentary evidence if you wish to disagree. Anyway, I probably ought to come up with some kind of fetching shot, shouldn't I? You know, that's a traditional kind of thing. Eight, nine. Nine passengers does not a railroad make. I'm going to give you just another couple of seconds and then you can start. And now my trains are much better spaced. Great. Okay. Well, let's wrap it up there. Let's follow along with our friend. You see, it says pink. I set it to pink. Everything here should be pink. But nope, it's blue. Apart from the end carriage, which is pink. Unless I got the other one right and I've made the same mistake again. In which case, the passengers in this train, first class, is pink. Let's hop train. Hopping train. The Metro line, Ed, does not appear to want to take the colour. Huh, okay. Well, I can set it in line setup and I'll get to that when I replace the engine because it's too old. So we're going to leave these running. If they pay off and they start making a couple of quid a year, that will help the overall striving that we have going on towards a staggering and unexpected dramatic victory. Buses, do your work. We've got some building going on, that's a good sign. But yeah, I think these are going to take a little longer than normal to get up to any kind of level of profitability. So tune in next time in order to keep up on the state of affairs. Because we can bankroll these guys expanding, but what I really want to do is get back into getting goods set up. And that's what we'll do next time. I suspect I'll have the cash for... I mean, look at the amount of people I've got waiting. That's just ridiculous. I have to be some kind of idiot not to start expanding on this stuff. I know. I mean, there's only 81 passengers allowed on that train, and it's going to take them all, and there's still going to be another 80-odd wait... 90 waiting. Perfect. Ho-hum. Anyway, thanks very much for watching today. I've been Colonel Failure. Next time out, we will do goods. Goods and ships. It might end up being a two-parter because it's quite a big job. But chuck a like on this one if you enjoyed it. Thank you. And subscribe if you've not yet done so. And I'll catch up with you very soon. Thanks for watching. That was quite high. Cheerio.